Meanwhile, joining us here in the studio to give some tips to adventure seekers is MYLES DELFIN, an adventure writer and photographer whose work has appeared in major adventure and travel magazines in the Philippines. He is the team leader for GeoStride Adventure Racing and participated in the search and rescue on Mount Maculot on the 3rd of April and searched around the base of the Rockies. Good afternoon, MYLES. Thanks for joining us.
Good afternoon, TJ.
Well, this is a bit of a sad story, isn't it? I mean, it's been how many days now? We're April 10th, so it's been seven days. Do you find that there still is hope?
Well, at the current situation, nobody wants to say that we're the rescuers are losing hope. Mm-hmm. We're all very optimistic. Mm-hmm. And we're all continuing to try and find clues. Because as of now, we don't have a lot to work with, as you know. The first time we got to Mount Maculot, there was absolutely no clue, no lead whatsoever to work with. Mm-hmm. The only thing we had to work with was that the storekeeper at the campsite said that he saw Victor at the campsite. He was supposedly bought water there, and that was it.
That's it.
So, but going on that, nobody knows exactly if he was on his way up or he was on his way down. Mm-hmm. So, basically, we had the entire mountain.
And what were the conditions like on that day?
It was pretty good, actually. Mm-hmm. Summer. Weather was very clear. Mm-hmm. A lot of people going up and down, the day hikers. Maculot is a very popular destination, as you know, for day hikers and climbers.
And it's an easy hike, would you say?
It's testing. I mean, you have to have some sort of physical fitness to enjoy it thoroughly. But yeah, anybody can climb Mount Maculot. It's not like Mount Halcon or Mount Giting where you need some sort of technical skill able to climb to the summit.
I think Victor was known as a mountaineer as well. I mean, right before this, he came from Romblon.
Mount Giting, actually. Okay. Mount Giting is a very technical climb. The base camp for Mount Giting is Mayo's Peak. And from there, you have to cross a knife's edge trail, which is very dangerous, actually. Mm-hmm. And then when you get to the other side, there's a 90-degree wall that you have to climb before you get to the summit. So compared to Mount Maculot, Giting really...
So the fact that he's been able to go to a more technical climb in another mountain, he's relatively a capable hiker.
Yes, it's a testament to his skill, actually, and his fitness. Mm-hmm. But the problem probably is that he was already tired when he got back from Giting, and then his friends tell me that he's an avid photographer. So everybody's guessing that he wanted to go to Mount Maculot, take pictures of the sunrise, because the sunrise on Mount Maculot is spectacular during the summer.
So he wanted to likely sleep over somewhere up there already and wait for the sunrise?
Actually, he went there very early in the morning, around 3 a.m., I think.
Yeah. That's the last time he was seen?
Yes.
By the storekeeper, 3 in the morning?
No, actually, he was seen by the storekeeper around 9 a.m.,
But is it advisable, actually, for hikers to go on their own? I mean, he is one that has done it before, but is this one of the tips that you would probably give, not to hike by yourself?
Well, in the Philippines, there's a discussion, actually, going on right now, whether it's safe to go solo or to go with a group. Mm-hmm. Of course, logic dictates that it's always safer to go with a group.
Right.
But there are climbers, there are adventurers in the Philippines who do know how to go solo in the mountains. And we have a lot of destinations that are not so hard to get to. So it's actually...
And would you say Maculot is one of those? That there are a lot of people who do it on their own?
Well, if you know the trail and if you have basic skills, I would say that Mount Maculot is a very safe destination.
And what is it for these hikers to do it alone? Is there a certain thrill that they want to do it alone? It's not the fact that they're loners, they don't have friends in the community, but maybe they just want to go up there by themselves?
Yeah. Well, there's a certain kind of pride that goes with it. When you're able to say that I'm at a level that I can walk alone in the forest or climb a mountain. So I guess that would be the primary motivation.
And he's a photographer as well, so I'm assuming that he didn't want to be maybe bogged down by a group. If he wanted to stop somewhere and want to take a photo, maybe this was one of his motives.
It's a possibility. I'm a photographer myself, so I actually do that also. I sometimes go on climbs, I sometimes go on bike rides alone, and then the primary reason is not because I'm a loner or I want to be alone or I'm antisocial, but because I want to be able to stop anywhere and anytime and take pictures.
Okay, let's talk about what we were mentioning to our viewers, the tips that you can give to these people who want to go on adventures in the summer, whether they are beginners in terms of going into conditions like these, or imagine more or less novice already with advances of technology, they may not be aware that there's some new things that could help them out.
Well, I actually wrote an article about that on my blog, geostride.com, but just to keep it short and simple, I would say that the first tip I would give is to keep it very simple. To be genuinely nice mm-hmm. to the people in the places that you go to. Okay. Because it might sound unimportant or trivial, mm-hmm. but actually it leaves an impression in the people. And if things like this happen, they remember you.
Okay.
And they care a lot more about what happens to you when, mm-hmm. when you leave that kind of impression with people. And they give you tips, they give you advice of mm-hmm. where to walk, what time, and what to watch out for example.
Mm-hmm. But that makes a lot of sense, actually.
Yeah.
Yes, it's very practical advice.
Mm-hmm. I remember when I was mountain biking in the trails behind Alabang Danghari.
Oh, there you
When are. You pass by these villages in the middle of nowhere, they always greet you each other, good morning.
Yes, exactly. Especially the
it's
kids.
Be nice, yeah, the kids, exactly.
Something like that. Like we're Filipinos.
Along those lines, yeah.
We're known for our smile. So yeah. Actually, the one thing that I would say, the very simple thing of smiling, that very simple act, it actually does a lot for you, for your safety also in isolated communities.
So that's step one. Be nice.
And then number two is don't do the things that you don't feel comfortable doing.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because you'd be surprised that sometimes adventure communities or adventure groups can be a little bit like high school.
Okay.
So there's a lot of peer pressure.
Cliquish.
Okay.
So for example, you're on an island, there's a pier, mm-hmm. and then everybody's jumping off the pier. But the problem is sometimes there are people in a group that are not comfortable in water, they're not so good at swimming, mm-hmm. but they get forced into these things.
Because everybody's doing it.
Because of peer pressure. And they don't want to be the one that said no and I'm afraid or something. Yeah. So actually, if you really care about your safety, just be honest to your friends. I don't think they're going to judge you anyway. You can be just the photographer taking pictures of people jumping off the pier, and that's okay also.
And sometimes to yourself, you have to know your limits
and say,
you know what, this is what I can handle.
Exactly.
And apart from that, I won't do it.
Don't go beyond your limits.
All right.
And then number three is there used to be a climbing gym, a rock climbing gym behind UP, Power Up. I used to go there a lot. They have a big poster about safety tips for climbing, and it says one of the best advice there is, it says, stack the odds in your favor.
Mm-hmm.
So this is where we bring in the technology for safety actually. Right. So when we say stack the odds in your favor, this is where research also comes in. Don't just jump into it. With today's technology, you can actually go on the internet, Google everything.
Yep.
And then go on Google Maps, check the trail, check the roads, mm-hmm. check the exit points, for example, even the towns near the area where you're going. Mm-hmm. And that's a very, very good thing to do for you, to have all the information that you need about the area where you're going. The next one, there's a device. I don't know if I can mention the brand, but there's a GPS, mm-hmm. GPS device. This is not the kind of GPS that you use for navigation.
Mm-hmm.
This is a GPS device that sends out information about where you are.
Oh, specific for hiking and these
specific
things.
Yes,
specific
for adventurers.
It's a tracker for you.
It's a tracker, actually.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that it's actually available in the local market. About 5 years ago, I was just looking at this in foreign magazines, and then I was thinking that I wish I had something like this. Mm-hmm. And now it's available locally.
Yeah.
So now, if you really want to be safe, you can just get that, and then your friends, your family can check out where you are exactly on the map online.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third one is, I don't know, I'm sure people know about this, but there are actually a lot of apps that are available.
Your phone, I was about to say,
exactly. Mm-hmm.
For Google, there's Latitude. There's for the iPhone, there's Find My iPhone.
Exactly.
As long as your phone's alive.
Exactly.
Still has battery.
You have to keep it charged.
For both Mac and Android devices.
Yes.
There are actually cases in the US, for example, where a guy's phone gets stolen and he finds it using those apps.
Exactly.
So, I mean, so that's crime fighting, but alternatively, you can also use that for safety in the
Uno.
And those were the latest news alerts for this hour. I'm Lexi Schultz. For more updates, check out our website, ancnews.tv.
You can also follow ANC Alerts on Twitter and YouTube and like our Facebook page, ANC 24/7. Stay tuned for Top Story that's coming up next here on ANC.